Welcome guys, in this session I will show you how to create a company and how to set users and password and tally auditing. Here I am just creating a company and here I am giving a tally valid password, if any. It is a default password for all members. Here use security control, it is the main option to set user accounts and to do. Here enable security control compulsory. Yes, here I am creating a authorized person account. The name of administrator is RR and the password for RR is the main authorized person for this tally admin. Okay, in company creation, use tally audit features. Yes, to do the auditing in your company, compulsory we need to set the option to yes. Use tally audit features. Yes. In company creation only we can do. In case you already created a company, just go to alter and change this option here. Enter the tally default password for all users is 5 zeros and here RR password is 5 ones. Tally will never accept the wrong password. Compulsory we need to specify the exact password what we given in informations. The exact password only Tally will accept. Okay, just accept now. Now it will accept the correct password. Accepted. I enable two features in company creation. Use security control, yes. And the one more, use tally audit features also, yes. First one check in accounts info, yes. The create also is opening and the display also opening. Is alter also, is opening for the authorized person. Okay, to create any users is okay. In gateway of Tally, press company information, alt F3, and here go to security control. The first option is user and password. Here we can create our all users, our all Tally users. Here I'm creating these dot entry operators, meant like our accountants. Here I'm giving the name is the A shift person name. Here we need to give here the A shift person name. Okay, by default here I am giving A shift and the separate password for A shift, and the B shift also is separate password for B shift. Here I am giving A shift password is for also A shift, the B shift password also B shift, and the C shift password also C shift. It is optional for owner because we already created the RRs. Here in case any auditor is coming through the net to do our company, that time compulsory we need to mention the auditor mail in our company users information. That time only Tally will accept the auditor mail address, otherwise Tally will never accept our address. Here we need to compulsory give any address for any auditor or CA. As I am giving my auditor at gmail.com, compulsory we need to give the any mail address. Here allow remote access, allow SMS functions, it can be used. Set the option here, Tally net user. Here also we can give the our net user mail ID so the user can avail our company with using up this mail address. Just accept. Here I just created these 5 accounts, 5 users in. See, once I will check with the login from the users. I am just setting the authorized person. Here nothing is there. Now again I am selecting company. The password is came. Select company and enter the default password here, 5 zeros. Enter. Here I am logging in with A shift person. Here one check with RR, his accounts info, ledgers, the 3 accounts is also opening, is ledger display alter, and here also the all is also available. Here I'm logging out the RRs user. Next, here we need to give a security control to our data users. Okay, because we need to do not give the any permission to alter any ledger for our data entry users. See, here there are two options. Is here, one is disallow, one is allow. Here is the disallow means is Tally will not give you a permission to disallow this. Here we need to give only the allow functions for the users. Here I'm giving allow for creation of my accounting standards and display accounting master standards. Here I'm giving a permission to create accounting vouchers. Next, account the display and print of accounting vouchers. It is dependent on our menu, how much of permission we need to give our accountants or data entry operators. It is dependent on our management. Permission will give only for creation of accounting ledgers and creation of inventory information. And creation of here, I am giving some default. I'll just show you. Here, I'm just allowing this following facilities to my data entry operators. Is three members, is A shift, B shift, and C shift. He is the data entry operators. Here, I'm just allowing this facility to do so in our company. Here also, I'm giving a create of inventory master, display and print of inventory masters. And here we need to disallow the following facilities which you want to disallow some settings for your data entry operators. The disallow facilities, I'm just allowing these facilities only for these users, A shift, B shift, and C shift. And tally.net users have the same feature as usual as data entry operators. The same things, creation of accounting vouchers and creation of inventory voucher. We did not give any permission to change a voucher, to delete a voucher, to delete a ledger. We do not give any permission to our accountants, means the data entry operators. Here also I am giving a permission for the same as usual what we given for data entry operators. This thing only I'm availing, I'm giving your information. Next, tally.net user. Here we are giving the permission to only for checking of our company's information. That permission only we need to give for auditor. Okay, as first time. Yeah, this permission only I'm giving to my auditor. Only for display and print of master, display and print of inventory information, display and print of accounting vouchers. That permission only I am giving here. When it is intimated, something went wrong in your company, okay, when it is intimated, that time only we need to give a permission to auditor for altering of our company's information. That time only we need to add a new facility in allow the following facilities, that is create. Here I'm create an alter. Here I'm just giving a permission for auditor only display and print, only checking for our errors and print the details. That permission only I'm giving. In further, when he is intimated as something went in your company, that time only we need to give a permission to our auditor for the creation of any. Here I'm giving. Okay, as usual I'm giving a permission also for. To create any accounting vouchers, to create inventory masters also I am giving here. By default we do not give any permission to create an alter. When he is intimated, that time only we need to give a permission for allow. until that time we do not give a permission for any data interpreters or even auditor also. Here I created 4 steps. Here I given some permissions, I disallowed some permissions to our employees. Next is activate password policy. Here we are giving just permission for the specified things, and here activate password policy at the for the changing of password of on the expiry date. Here we can allow these facilities. Yeah, now here I'm not enable this. Once you will check with login, yes, I'm closing. Now here I will open with a shift person. I will log in my company with a shift person. Yeah, that normal password for all members is 50, and here I'm logging with a shift person. The name of user is incorrect. Now the tally will not accept me. Again, I will change. One check here. See, it is not accepted because the name of username is wrong. Here I'm giving the correct name as a shift and the password also a shift. Enter. Now tally is accepted. See, it is not asking any change of passwords. See here, now it is allowed the all features for accounts information ledgers creation. It is allowing. Once come to the same way. Alt F3 security control. Here data entry operators. Here I'm disallowing the features. Whatever we enable, it is allowing the permission for creation, display and alter. But here we need to disallow the facility of alter. Means the accountant should never change our details, because in case is will do any frauds in our company, that so we need to give a security for our company. So that's why here I'm disallowing the following facilities. Here the first one, alter. Here I'm choosing first is alter. I'm just disallowing. I will just disallow some features. Here I'm disallowing the feature is alter for creation of accounting masters. I'm alter is accounting vouchers. Here I'm just disallowing these facilities to our employees. Audit program. So now the auditor will never change our data. The person here, just here we are giving permission only for creation of new ledgers and a display, but here we are not giving any permission to change the information of our ledgers or to change the information of our inventory. Here I'm also locking the alter inventory masters. The person cannot change our stock information. The person only can create a new stock, but the person cannot change the created stock items. Okay, it is also dependent on our management. I'm just giving I'm just locking some facilities for this. Okay, just accept the everything. Just accept as usual. Here also I'm logging the some facilities for tally.net users, accounting vouchers and inventory vouchers. So the person cannot change the created vouchers or accounting vouchers or inventory. The person cannot change our accounting vouchers either inventory vouchers. Here also I am locking some permission for auditor. Here I am disallowing some facilities is alteration of accounting vouchers, alteration of masters, alteration of inventory information. Here I am locking some facilities. I'm just disallowing some facilities. Just accept. Here once you will log in with here the password is not we are not giving any permission to change a password for our users. It's like A shift, B shift, C shift. Here I am giving a permission to change the password from the each login. Once you will check without enabling this feature, okay. Here now I will enter the default password 5 zeros for all users. And here I will enter with A shift person. The password also A shift. Now it is see. It is directly open without asking any new password for the user. Here, see in ledger creation, the first login it is enabled, but in this login it is locked for this user. So here the person can create any users, but the person cannot alter or delete our ledgers. And here also see we can just create our slog item, but the person cannot delete or change information. So here I'm creating HP printers. I just logged in with A-shift person. The person is doing some entries in our company. He is creating HP printers and the group is electronics. The number says can quantity is yes. I just created HP printers, accept. See here, it is allowing permission for only display and creation. Now it is the alteration keys locked for this user. So the person can create any new stock item, the person can create any ledger, but the person cannot modify our created information. The person can only see our information, the person cannot check any values. Again I visited, enter default password. Here I am logging with RR. Here I will show you the third feature. See it is allowing for the all members. All features it is allowing for the authorized person. Okay, so now the person can edit anything. So like this also the person can enter anything. So the owner only can edit the created things. So now it is allowed for the alteration key is allowed only for our owner. So here now I will allow opening with this the B shift person. He will log in with the daily with this user and password. Here he is creating some share. It is all the alter key also locked for BA person also, B shift person also, the key is locked. See, on the login form, login for the A shift and login for the B shift, it is not asking for any change of new password. It is not asking. Compulsory we need to give a permission to change the password for our all users. Here go to Alt F3 security control. Here choose the password policy. Here I'm just activating the password policy. The minimum password length is 8 numbers. We can set this see here password expires after. So after expiring this is the our users cannot access our company with password all, even the password also the person cannot access our company. So here the use notify the users before the expiration. Here I'm just giving 10 days. Now Tally will notify the users. The last option allow permission to change the password for user. I'm just allowed yes, set yes. And here I'm just creating this C shift. I'm just logging with C shift. Now we already enable the features. Change the password on first login. I just said set yes. So now Tally will ask the password changing for the C shift. See, now it is asking for change password. Current password for C shift. Now the user can change the user password, and the password expiry date is 90 days. New password here also I'm giving. Here we can see the password strength is it is in weak, strong, fair. Yeah, like that it will show. See, nothing is there should to show. Here I am giving a simple password for issue to person. Just continue. Yeah, we already set that at least must 8 digits. Here I'm giving a separate password for my users. See the key also locked for say the C shift person also it is locked because he is one of the user, one of the data entry operator in our company. See here he is doing some duties in our company. Actually capital accounts comes under capital by mistakenly is taking as indirect expenses. And next rent received comes under actually indirect income, but by mistake is taking as indirect expenses. Okay. And here he is creating his purchases. Purchase accounts. Next sales accounts. Next salaries. Okay, salaries comes under actually indirect expenses. By mistake is taking salaries comes under sales accounts. Actually it is indirect expenses. It should post in profit and loss account. Credit side but debit side, but it is showing now it will show as wrong profit and loss account. Here if the person also creating some stock information in our company. Yeah, he is passing some vouchers. The receipt is a capital rupees. Is it 10,000? Actually capital is selected by under group is indirect expenses. Actually capital comes under capital account. Okay, again one more mistake is entered in our company. It is salaries comes under indirect expenses, but here by mistake is taken as salaries comes under sales accounts. One more mistake also is venting in vouchers. See here it is not allowing to change the modify this. The owner only can modify this. See here now it is showing. Press Alt F1 here. See. The salaries actually it should post in profit and loss account debit side by mistakenly is chosen salaries comes under sales account. That's why it is showing on here as trading account. And as usual capital also comes under it will post in balance sheet. By mistake it is chosen indirect expenses. See now capital now here it is not showing any capital account, so the total accounting is wrong. Now here I will log in with A shift person. If you A shift person also will do some entries. Now it is asking the change password for A shift. Now here I am changing the password. Okay, just save that. Capital, now it is not allowing any permission to change that, you know, but he can't change any details in our company. So he is also creating the new ledgers, his garage outwards. Actually it should post in profit and loss account. By here is indirect expenses, by here is the person is taking as direct. Okay, sorry, is taking as correct indirect expenses. Carriage outwards come now here, carriage inwards, it will post in trading account direct expenses, but the person is taking as indirect expenses. The one more mistake is went by a shift person. He is also passing some vouchers. He also entered some mistakes. So here carriage outwards is also showing in profit loss account. Carriage inwards also showing in profit loss. So that is wrong. He also passing a new entries, it's commission. Is passing commission, actually commission in BR receiving. Okay, by mistake is taking as expenses, so that will post in profit loss account expenses side. So that is also wrong. He is also passing some entries. Is also purchasing some goods from Mr. X party without giving reference number. Is passing the voucher, so that is not a mistake, but the information is not correct. Okay, actually here we are purchasing for cash. By mistake is also he already taken mistakes for purchases. Again by mistake is chasing for sales also is taking Mr. X, so that is also wrong. Now here I will log in with another ID. I mean just entering a normal password for all members. Here I will find out some entries, who is entered mistake, who is entered correct. Now here I will do the auditing for the members. I just log in with my account, my main account. Here now I can alter anything because I'm authorized to. I just have a all permission to change this all things. Here to audit, go to display, statement of accounts, tally audit. Here the three persons is entered, this entry already entered two entries, the A shift person is entered is 9 entries, the B shift is 8. Here the total ledgers is created is 11 ledgers. Here we can do the audit by voucher wise or master wise or user wise. We can do the audit for the three options. See here I am doing as voucher wise. Here the receipt voucher is which capital is entered by C shift, commission is entered by A shift, and mistakes also is entered by A shift. So go to display statement of accounts. Next tally out here. I'm just following the first thing is voucher types. This here just press control enter. See, salaries actually comes under indirect. If by mistake it chosen salary, so here it is altered by the owner is correctly. Now it is correct, right? Now it is corrected by entered by RR. So just click on F7 to accept the correct voucher. F, just give you a path on correct voucher, then press F7 to accept the voucher to as audit. The internal auditing. Next, carriage inwards. One check here. Carriage inwards is direct expenses. Actually, it is a direct expense. It will post in trading account direct expenses. Now it is also corrected by the owner. Just accept the carriage inwards. Is it right? Now it is okay. Nothing is there to audit. That is finished. Next, in purchase voucher is only one. Now here I will follow the as master wise a ledger. Here we can check any it is the right means. Just click on F7. That will go as auditor. That will consider as auditor. Next, capital. Here, capital comes under is in capital account. By mistake is taking indirect. Here it is also altered by the owner. Now it is right. So press F7 to accept this. Like that, we need to do a auditing. The rent received is indirect income. Right, click on F7. Now I will follow the third one is users. User wise auditing here. The RR is entered 3 entries and A shift is 6 entries and the C shift also 4 entries. Here I choose an A shift person is entered 2 ledgers and purchase voucher, sales voucher. His commission is it is okay, so click on F7. Next, Mr. X also F7, that is also accepted. Now the vouchers only in pending for A shift is entered only one voucher in May, entered by A shift. So one check in this is Mr. X, okay, right? So we can accept this. Is it right? It is okay. Now that is also audited. Now here I chosen C shift is entered 2 entries, 2 ledger creation and 2 vouchers, 2 receipt vouchers. Now it is also correct. So click on F7 to accept the correct ones. That is also audited. Like that, we need to do a auditing. That is also audited. To check the final statement of auditing, okay, in here in gateway of tally, audit complaints, audit analysis. Here we can check that. Here 8 is audited. Click on subscribe to more videos. Thank you.